Alright, hello, fun and welcome back to SimSettlements 2 Chapter 3, where today we are in the main menu because, oh boy, off camera something big happened, and I want to just load straight into the save before it happens so that we don't miss anything. Basically, I was working off camera on that one warfare mission where I've got to take the different gunner territories. I figured I'd take two of the three off cam and do the final one with you guys. Problem is, I literally did the first one, and then a conversation started over the HQ radio, which at first I was just like, oh, okay, cool, it'll tell me to go back to GNN and then we'll have a conversation with someone. Nope, it kept talking, and then the person on the radio claimed to be the inventor of the ASAM, so I was like, oh, I should quit out of the game right now. And so I'm hoping, I've got a couple of saves. This was from just after launching the flare. That was the autosave there. And so I'm assuming this is the autosave after the fact, after we won. Problem is that the thing that I'm worried about is that this save is like 5 minutes after, and I'm worried about that. I know that I did pause the game briefly because I was sitting here thinking of what to do, but I don't remember pausing for that long, so, Oh well, let's click this one and see what happens. I'm pretty sure that's gonna be after. If not, we'll just do the battle again from this one here. So let us jump into the game, which, boy, it was a lot trying to actually find places where we could go to attack. There was a list on the SimSettlements 2 Chapter 3 wiki of potential places the gunners could be, so that was awesome. But it's not guaranteed other people could be there too. And I kept going to them, just going down the list, and I was like, oh great, bandits, oh great, super mutants. Oh hey, I finally found a gunner place, and oh, it was too far away from any of my outposts. I was like, ah, come on. But yeah, I finally found this one. It's the Poseidon Energy Facility over by Quincy, which surprisingly Quincy wasn't on the list for a territory you can tackle, but oh well, the Poseidon Energy place was, and there were gunners there, so I went to take it. I'm a little bit worried, though, because I'm like halfway through the list at the point where you reach the Poseidon Energy thing, and I've only done one. I did find, like I said, that other, I don't remember, it was one of the arrays. I think it was over by Fort Hagen, whatever that array over there is. That place was full of gunners, but marked it with the binoculars, launched the flare, and too far away from outpost. Oh. So that's unfortunate. Only one of the two places I find. Okay, oh boy, are we done? Everyone's standing around. Are we? Let's check what is in the data. Okay, so that is why it was still 5 minutes, the exit save. Got it. So I didn't actually realize this, there's an autosave during the reinforcement phase, huh? Oh, that's nifty. Wait. No, I bet there isn't. I wasn't getting the reinforcements to come, as per usual, so I waited, and there's an autosave with waiting. Ah, that's what that is. All right. Well, let's hold Poseidon Energy, and hopefully... Oh, yep, there's the enemies. Lovely. Oh, thank God. So just finish this battle, and then hopefully we should be able to talk to whatever that person was over the radio. Also, dear God, there are so many beams flying everywhere, I can't see a darn thing. Of course. All right, that one's down. That's just a conscript. They should die pretty easily. Got it. Okay, and just those two left. Lovely. And... Oh God. Die, please. Got it. All right. That actually went better than when I was doing this off camera. Because unfortunately, never mind. I was about to say, oh, there they are. I was about to say the reinforcements spawned like almost inside of Quincy. And yeah, okay. It looks like it did that again. Got it. Holy crap. There's a lot of them. Oh, okay. Yeah, this is going to take a little bit. Amusing that these guys were right there, though. Oh god. All right. Come around the corner here. Oh god, don't shoot our own guy. Or that one there.
Glad that's
okay, over. That one's dead. Now we've just got that whole bundle over there. Are they coming to us? They seem to be coming to us. Good, 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 good. Because when I was doing it off cam, I went over there to fight them and got in the middle of all the gunners and Quincy too. So it didn't work out for us very well. I ended up fighting a lot more people. Oh, those ones. Cool. Well, they seem to be coming towards us too, so that's good. Looks like these guys are going over there. Where? Oh, there they are. There they are. Wonderful. Die, please. Would appreciate that very much. Thank you for cooperating, sir. Okay, and Chuck at the... Oh, he's over there now. Never mind. It was a complete waste of... I'm out of grenades. Where's a body? Surely... Oh, God, you guys are all down, huh? Well... We're gonna have a lot of injured, aren't we? Alright, I see that one. Come on, die. Ooh, we might get another good one. Oh, we hit the tree. Oh, it was the, you know, the death camera shot too, following him over there, but then it hit the tree. Got it. Alright, cool, 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 cool. So there's just those ones over there. I don't feel like waiting. Let's roll. Stag him down. And hi, guys. Oh, I just tried to throw a grenade. I immediately remembered. Oh, yeah, I'm out now. We literally just ran out of grenades. All right. Die, Corporal. There we go. Where is that person's body floating to? Oh, no grenade on him. That's unfortunate. They're fighting. Yep, they're fighting those guys over there. Cool, 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 cool. Yeah, you know what? You can handle them now. Okay, okay, okay. This one right there. You know, I should have used a crit. Oh, well. Oh, God, reload. And... finish him off. No grenades, dang. Can't believe I actually ran out of grenades. Oh, my God, we're just... Wait, what? There was a dude here, right? He seems to have disappeared. Hello? Hello? How'd you end up over here, friend? Wipe out Poseidon energy. I mean, that's what we're working... I'm hitting the tree every... There we go. Yeah, okay. And... Did that get it? Hey! We got it! Yes! Alright, so now... Oh, God, there's fighting over here. Of course there is. The Peabody House... Oh God, I'm about to go in through the cutscene, aren't I? Let's hide behind here so I don't get shot. Waiting for it. Waiting for it. There it goes. And there we are, the first of three territories. And then hopefully, assuming it does the same thing as last time, I should now get a call over the radio with someone claiming to be the inventor of the ASAM. Wow, we actually did an S, huh? I don't believe that. With 9 injuries, we got S rank? I don't believe that. Oh well, got it. And our people are still fighting, which means more are gonna get injured. Oh, and I gotta now tell them all to go home. There really needs to be a go home everyone button. Alright, I hear all the fighting still going. Cool, 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 cool. Okay, radio now, please. Or just stay. There we go, there we go. Stays on that for too long. Okay, so what will we have? I probably should help them go kill those last couple of gunners, because they're probably going to just end up going deeper into Quincy, but, oh no, I really should, because then, oh, wait, yep, there you go, radio time. Okay, alright, I can't move, but nothing's happening. You know, I should have quick saved before this happened. Because, oh, there it goes. Hello. Oh, thank God. I thought it broke for a moment. So who's this?
Who is this?
Ah, finally. It's about damn time.
Mm-hmm.
I am the Dr. K.S. Magnuson.
Uh-huh.
Inventor of the Comm Hub, what you know as ASAMs.
Sweet.
Not to mention a myriad of other groundbreaking technologies.
Got it. So you're a ghoul now?
I say, young lady, that today is your lucky day.
Doesn't sound like a ghoul, though.
You are about to receive guidance from quite possibly the most brilliant mind left in the wasteland.
Nifty.
On the off chance that you are a simpleton, I am referring to me.
Okay, so the guy doesn't sound like a ghoul. Oh, there's still more. I'm going to get shot while on this radio, aren't I? So I see a couple of options here for him still being alive. Either he is a ghoul and somehow doesn't sound like a normal ghoul. He was frozen like we were. Or brainbot. That's possible, too. Oh, or AI. He might not be the actual person. He might be an AI copy, maybe? That's a thing. So, sorry, who are you now?
Sorry. Who are you?
Oh, God, you are simple. That or being in the wastes for so long has addled your mind. Very well.
I like
listen
him.
Listen carefully. I am Magnuson, once heralded as one of America's greatest heroes.
Oh, soldier, really?
Astronaut, inventor, genius visionary.
Ooh.
I'm sure you'll have seen me on TV or read about me in the newspaper at some point.
Tell me more.
Tell me more.
The devices you and your partner have been using all over the Commonwealth, they are of my design.
Lovely.
The ASAMs, the Comm Hub, I invented these. It is thanks to my genius alone that you have had the tools to do what you have.
And wonderful.
Now, I come to offer you personal guidance.
Excellent. That'd be great. That'd be great. I'm gonna go with this one.
Thanks, I guess.
Don't you worry. I'll attempt to keep things nice and simple so that you'll be able to follow along.
I appreciate
now,
it.
Ever since you reactivated the Comm Hub, I have been aware of your activities.
Have you?
I know about your efforts to rebuild the Commonwealth, and of your fight against the group called the Gunners. And for the most part, I have approved.
Most part.
However, due to technical difficulties, I have been unable to make direct contact to offer assistance. Until now, at least.
Got it. Took you this long, huh?
It took this long to make contact?
As I said, there were complications. But whilst I may have been unable to talk with you, that doesn't mean I was content to sit on my laurels.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, we gotta ask.
You really from before the war?
Something of a cynic, are we? The Great War, or something like it, was inevitable. It was only prudent that I and others like me took the necessary precautions to see us through.
Right. But what was it? I need to know which of my theories it is. Well, go on.
Go on.
Since I was not able to speak with you, I decided to instead monitor Gunner communiques and redirect anything that appeared relevant or critical via the Comm Hub.
Oh.
Allowing you and your partner to overhear the Gunners and prepare yourselves accordingly.
So that's how that happened.
I am glad to see that you have been using this to your advantage.
Thank you for that. We'll go with this one first.
How did you find us?
It wasn't difficult. As soon as you activated the Comm Hub, my lab's mainframe connected automatically. You see, the hub was meant to be interfaced with a local satellite station, allowing me to supervise a personal project.
Oh, cool.
Instead, I've been receiving data and radio chatter from you, your partner, and every single person who happens to be using an ASAM.
Oh, there's a lot of those now.
I cannot imagine the sheer amount of inane drivel I've had to endure.
So they're all listening devices? That seems... Well, let's be honest, that seems about on par for pre-war America. Oh, boy. All right, so every single home, business, etc. is all being wiretapped by this dude. Got it. Monitored, huh?
Monitored? What do you mean?
In their infinite wisdom, the Gunners have commandeered one of my auxiliary radio towers, tying it to their network.
Oh.
As such, I've been privy to a fair number of sensitive communications.
Neat.
I decided it best to forward some of these transmissions to you and your partner.
Why only some?
Comm Hub, indirectly providing you with useful intelligence and valuable insight into the Gunners' movements and plans.
Got it. But why only some? Yeah, so it was you, huh?
So it was you.
Yes, it was me. All hail Magnuson, glorious defender of the wasteland.
I'm gonna have fun with this dude.
My intervention alone that you managed to keep one step ahead of the Gunners all this time. So, you're welcome.
Well, thank you.
But simply playing telephone is no longer enough. If you're to win this war of yours, you'll need more than overheard radio chatter.
Indeed.
You may have noticed the gunners have equipped themselves with some interesting new weaponry. Energy weapons, nuclear devices, all courtesy of their employer.
Yeah, who is that, by the way?
They're not the only ones who can play that game.
Ooh.
I'm forwarding you coordinates to a pre-war cache. It'll have equipment that can help you. You should acquire its contents as soon as you are able.
Okay, we're doing that today. So, what's in it?
What's in the cache?
I'd have thought the term equipment self-explanatory, but if you must know, the cache contains food, medical supplies, precious materials, all of which will be useful here at HQ, I'm sure.
I was hoping for weaponry.
The piece de resistance, the first step to ending your war against the gunners. The Stheno.
The what now?
But I'll leave the details of that as a surprise.
How rude. How rude. Yeah, why are you helping?
Why are you helping me?
The gunners' actions threaten more than just the Commonwealth. If they're not stopped, America's best hope for a future dies.
Uh-huh. He probably means himself. A pre-war cache, huh? Interesting.
Pre-war cache, huh? This'll be interesting.
Provided the seals have held, you'll be the first thing to have set foot inside in over 2 centuries. So, do try not to scuff the carpet.
Oh, it's got carpet?
Travel to Wildwood Cemetery.
Got it.
Should still be there. In one of the mausoleums, there's a false tomb. Inside, a ladder leading to a small bunker.
Sweet.
Enter, and when prompted, speak the passcode. Moonlight's burning. You'll then gain access to the equipment. There'll be a gun there. Take it.
Well, I mean, of course I am. I'm a looter.
Soon. Until then, I'd consider it a personal favor if you didn't get yourself killed.
You know, I definitely try not to.
Too much at stake, and your demise is not something I care to factor into my calculations.
Oh, yeah, he definitely meant himself when he was... Oh, wait. Oh, I put my gun away. We're gonna have another radio call. Oh, boy. Uh-huh.
Hey, darling.
Hi.
Didn't mean to eavesdrop, but that radio call was being piped to the comm array. We heard the whole thing.
Ah, cool.
You really think that was Magnuson?
Probably.
The guy who 200 years ago invented ASAMs?
I mean, I'm from 200 years ago, so it's possible.
The same guy whose office we were in.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I'm from 200 years ago. It's certainly possible. There's multiple ways it could be. But, yeah, what do you think happened?
What do you think happened to him?
Who knows? But the guy was definitely some kind of genius. If there was anyone who could find a way to survive the end of the world, it'd be him. For now, I think we should do what Magnuson says.
Agreed.
We should visit this cache of his. Find out what kind of goodies he's offering to help us fight the gunners with. All right, then. Good luck. And be safe.
Thanks, Jake. All right. Outside assistance now. Wonderful. Oh, God. Where'd all my people go? Jeez. Thankfully, none of them died in the initial battle, but... I don't know about since. Considering how close we are to very bad areas. Oh, boy. How many of you are here that I can send home? Oh, jeez. I'm actually tempted to not send them home and do this later off cam, but let's at least get the couple that I can see right now. And then we'll fast travel away. See, I can only see those three, and I think I saw someone over here. Yeah, that person right there. Got it. Hi, you. Oh, you're wounded, huh? Oh, boy, pretty badly. Oh, well, go away. You can get treated back home. That's four of them. We had a lot more. Oh, well, I'll do that off camera. I don't feel like finding the others right now. So we need to go to here. Let's turn these off for now. And go up to the Wildwood Cemetery. Which apparently I don't know about in this world. Cool, 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 cool. Go for Ten Pines Bluff. Yeah, it seems like a good place. It'll be safe. Man, yeah, we really need to explore more of the map of this save file. I keep forgetting how many things we don't have explored. good times, good times, good times. Alright, well, down there, face the ghouls at Wildwood Cemetery, and then, yeah, head inside a nifty vault and figure out what at that, what was it, Stetson or something along those lines? Whatever that weird thing was he said will be a surprise. I'm intrigued to see what that's gonna be. I hear building noises. Odd that that was showing me everything before. Apparently, I helped defend the Red Rocket truck stop. Don't remember doing that. I don't even remember that ever popping up as a thing. Oh, well. Oh, well. Also, boy, it's going to drive me crazy. What was that one place I was talking about earlier that I couldn't get? Ah, Fort Hagen. Oh, it was just Fort Hagen Satellite Array. So apparently, that is out of range of that, which is unfortunate. I have been wondering what in the world the range is of these, and well, that gives us a bit of an answer. Okay, yeah, that one's pretty close. So that is doable. But that is not. Got it.
Wait, what?
Oh, Sunshine Tidings. Yeah, that's a... That's a Nuka World Raider thing. Got it, got it, got it. I forgot that's over there. Alright, let's get rolling. This way. And try and avoid things. Actually, is that a territory we can take up there? I mean, I don't know if it'll count towards the territories in question. Considering there was the list on the wiki. But it'll be a problem for off-camera. Okay, gun out. And just about there. So we need to head into, looks like, that mausoleum right there. Neat. And since I haven't been here before on this particular save, we're definitely going to encounter a fair number of ghouls. Well, yeah, I see them. Cool, 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 cool. Take out that one. And boop. It's dead. They're dead. Missed. Oh, wow. I actually did get them. Oh, my God. There's a lot more than I thought. Oh, and I'm out of grenades. I just remembered. Do I have Molotov? There we go. There we go. Kill the glowing one. Kill the glowing one. Okay, thankfully they were all low-level ghouls, so they mostly died to the Molotov. Sweet. Alright, that's always great. Yeah, okay, let's go to the thing. Oh, no, God, stuck in a tree, of course. Okay, so yeah, that mausoleum right there, it looks like. Actually, it's slightly off. Huh? Oh, it's in there, but like over to the side. Got it, got it, got it. I figured it'd be a bit more centered. Nope, over to the side. Okay, how do I get? Ah, okay. Nifty. It's literally just a hatch inside of a coffin. Cool, 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 cool. Okay, well, let's see what we got. Oh, what was the password he gave us again? Pack of cigarettes. No, lovely vase. Beer bottles. What do we got? More dead. Okay, wasn't expecting it to be more of a crypt down here. But, okay, alright, fair enough. What's you? Oh, nothing. It kind of looked a bit glowing, so I thought maybe it was a note. Nope. Doesn't look like anything of value here. A sleeping bag. Alright. Okay, so we got those. Lovely. Let's see. So around the corner. I'm surprised we're actually not encountering any ghouls in here right now. Considering where we are, why is that boarded up there? Weird. Sledge. Oh, hello, gold. Yeah. I mean, it's gonna be super heavy, but oh well, I'll take it all. Scrap that. Nice. Okay. Yeah, genuinely surprised there's not any ghouls down here. I mean, it works for me. Alright, so there's that door. But, still gotta check things. How are you still lit? Oh, a novice lock? Child's play.
Nice.
It would have been hilarious if I would have broken a bobby pin right when I said it. You have entered security zone. Lethal force may be used without further warning. Nice. All right. Well, I mean, let's do the thing. Hey. Intercom.
Warning. You are in violation of a security zone. Use of lethal force is imminent.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But I have... Moonlight's burning.
Moonlight's burning.
Sweet. The security thing got cut off, though. All right. Find Steno. And loot every other bloody thing in here. What did the rest of that say, though? And other supplies. Yeah, so loot every bloody thing in here. Yeah, got it. Got it. Good. We're gonna be okay. All right. Ooh, we got a holotape audio log. Heck yeah. Want a Nuka-Cola? Let's play this.
Rocket brand ASAM sensors. America's number one sensor solution.
Uh-huh.
Once again, dullard, you demonstrate your ignorance.
Okay.
I'm afraid you wasted your time showing me this concept pitch of yours. The ASAM sensors, as you've dubbed them, are but one small part of my project, and I've no interest in turning them into a commercial labor substitute for Robco.
Well, too bad, because that's what's going to happen.
You misunderstand. This wasn't a concept pitch for your approval. No. That was an advertisement for an authorized new product.
Uh-huh.
We've already begun pre-production. Hey, we're even in talks to partner with Vault-Tec. Hence the presence of their chief procurement officer.
What are you talking about, Mallard?
They moved your plan along.
I told you, the board expected something of value in return for your funding.
I mean, yeah, that's fair.
But since you were unwilling, or... one of your staff instead took the initiative, refining your research into something practical.
Oh.
You know, perhaps with this, we can finally start recouping some of the losses from funding your cockamamie Project Selene.
Project Selene?
Now, you listen here.
No, Mr. Magnuson, you listen. As the clause in subsection 5 of your contract dictates, with the delivery of any viable product, a contractor's employ is open to amendment or conclusion.
Oh, they're taking his tech and kicking him out.
Now delivered by your research, I declare your contract terms fulfilled.
Mm-hmm.
How dare you bastardize my work with this half-baked product! You know what's coming. We must see my project to completion.
I want to know what that project is.
Your time working for Robco Industries. You have an hour to gather your belongings and vacate the premises.
Oh, okay. So he was making the ASAMs for something much bigger, for, you know, the end of the world whole thing with this Project Selene. What exactly it was, I'm intrigued. And then Robco, well, one of his employees backstabbed him, Robco screwed him, took his tech, and fired him. Corporate America, heck yeah. All right, well, looks like we've got a couple of other holotapes here, and I just noticed the time, so we'll actually... Oh, there's the Steno. Wait, it looks like... Hold on a moment. It looks like a more fully complete version of the induction rifle. Oh, is whoever's funding them, like, someone from the... I forget the guy's name. The guy's past? Oh, my. Or someone who's found, like, his other research or something along those lines. Oh, my God, I want all these things, but I will not have the carry capacity. Interesting. All right, well, that's probably going to trigger something when we pick it up. So next episode, we'll come back and take a look at these audio logs and then grab the gun and see what else is... Okay, not really anything in here of value. Got it. A sealed Boston Bugle. Ooh. Nifty. But yeah, next episode, we'll listen to those next two audio tapes and roll from there. Hopefully you all have enjoyed this one today, and you do come back for the next one. Until that time, thank you for watching. As always, we'll have a good one.